I've been using Puppet and Chef for almost a decade now before I started with Ansible. That was back in 2014, so I've been using it for about 4 years. And here are the top five reasons why I love Ansible. The first and the foremost is the simplicity. It is so simple. It's simple to set up, simple to learn. I mean, you can get started really quickly with Ansible. You can understand the concept probably in a week's time and be a master of Ansible, at least writing playbooks and managing your infrastructure. And you can get started very, very quickly. There's not a lot of learning curve when it comes to Ansible. The language that is used is pretty simple. It's a simple English, like a natural language, like code that we write with YAML. So it was extremely, the simplicity is what really struck me when I started using Ansible, since I had actually came with the complex tools, with the knowledge of complex tools, and I had spent a good amount of time learning those tools. So simplicity is the first thing that I love about Ansible. And it's not just about learning and setup of Ansible, it's also about when you really want to extend Ansible, it's really simple to do that, because I know how painful it is to write a plugin, or you know, like when you want to extend Chef or Puppet, because you have to be a Ruby, you have to learn Ruby. So unless you're a Ruby guy, you're gonna find it sort of difficult to extend and write custom code for Puppet or Chef. Whereas with Ansible, it's pretty simple. When you want to extend, and you will need to extend at some point of time, you'll need to write some custom modules and plugins and so on. It's pretty simple to do that. And even though Ansible itself is written in Python, you don't have to be a Python expert to really extend it, because you can write even a shell script and write a wrapper around it and convert it into an Ansible module as well. So simplicity is the first reason I love Ansible. Now, the second reason is sophistication, because a lot of times you'll find that a tool which is really simple, it really fails when you start extending things and doing more sophisticated things. That's not the case with Ansible. And I have found it to be very useful when I really wanted to do really complex setup, like provisioning of a big data infrastructure, do some sort of auto discovery. For example, one of the interesting feature I found when I started with Chef was search. With search, you could actually do auto configuration, discover all the services in that cluster, get that detail and put it in the configuration in an automated way as well. Now, Chef uses a complex approach to do that, because Chef has an actual indexing and search engine running in the background. Chef has so many moving components when it talks about Chef server, whereas Ansible, it's pretty simple, and they have a very simple approach to this auto discovery with magic variables and facts caching. So it actually stores it in a, even in a file, or you can just put a memcache or Redis backend, which is really simple to integrate with, right? And there are so many different features of Ansible. When you want to write some complex logic, when you want to write conditionals, do conditional execution based on some other some other task and so on, when you want that sophistication, the point is it is also possible with Ansible, and that's just amazing. So it's not only simple, but at the same time it is pretty sophisticated when you need it to be, really, right? That's the second point. Now the third point is the versatility that Ansible offers. Because if you look at, let's say, Puppet and Chef, they're good for configuration management. They're primarily configuration management tool. Now, Chef has extended it to a lot of other features, but primarily these are configuration management tools. But if you are an ops guy and a DevOps guy, you know that it's not just configuration management tool that you need, and it's not going to be completely automated setup all the time. Sometimes you may just want to log in and check something, get some information, or maybe just run one-time command or get some information from a bunch of servers and do that in parallel. So in addition to Chef and Puppet, you still may need to use some sort of parallel SSH tool, or you may want to just write a for loop. Now, Chef supports knife SSH, but the approach that Ansible takes is much more sophisticated than that, and you can do connect to a bunch of servers, run things in parallel, do that with multiple types of filters and so on. So you can do ad hoc server management, you can obviously do the configuration management. Not only that, when it comes to provisioning, since it is a push approach, Ansible is much better when you want to provision the infrastructure on cloud. Now, you also have specialized tools like Terraform, which are useful when you really want to do like, you know, really sophisticated provisioning on multiple clouds. But when you want to provision something on cloud, and it's, if it is pretty simple as creating a VM or creating a cloud server, Ansible can definitely do that as well. And apart from that, you can also use it for application deployment, certain features that I'm going to come back to that point in probably my last point for this video. So it's versatile and it can let you do multiple things, and it can actually replace a bunch of things with just one simple tool that is Ansible. That's the versatility. The fourth point that I have is the batteries included approach. Now, again, I keep comparing it with Chef and Puppet because that's something I've been using extensively. So when you want to do things like, you know, you want to integrate with a cloud, when you want to, you know, do some management of more resources and entities, maybe in maybe a cloud server, maybe a network device, maybe a storage device, maybe integrate with Slack or some messaging tool or emails, you have to rely on the plugin system that the Chef or Puppet has. So either you use plugins, or you write some custom resources to do that, right? Or use some custom resources written by someone else. Now, when you compare it with Ansible, Ansible comes with all these batteries included. It actually has, Puppet has about like 50 or less than 100. Chef has more than 100 entities that it can manage. But when you talk about Ansible or compare it with Ansible, Ansible comes with about 1600 modules. I checked last, a little more than 1600 modules. And those are the number of entities that you can actually manage with Ansible out of the box. You are not talking about plugins, no additional resources. These are the resources, these are the modules that come with Ansible pre-built. And that's just amazing. So you want to manage network devices, you want to manage a cloud platform, cloud and, you know, entities, you want to manage or integrate with email clients, messaging databases even. You have a lot of things out of the box, and that's just fantastic. I don't have to go looking for plugins or custom roles and things like that with Ansible. Most of the times, it gets the job done for me out of the box, and that's amazing. And the fifth point that I have for today is the push approach that Ansible follows, and it is really, really useful at times. Even though push has some limitation, I'm going to talk about limitations of Ansible in another video, which I would link here. But when you talk about, let's say, application deployment, a lot of times you may want to do certain things in certain sequence, especially with application deployment and orchestration, where you want to stop load balancer, go and update schema, come back and update data, application servers, go back and forth, do some configurations here and there. You may want to wait for the application to actually come up and then proceed with the next step. So all of these things become really easy with Ansible, and you don't have to go looking for a specialized application deployment tool to achieve this, really, right? And that is some, those are the 5 points I really find you know, really interesting, and that I've been in love with Ansible, and these are some of the reasons why I really like this tool. Its simplicity, the versatility, the sophistication that it offers, and all of this is sort of out of the box, and I've been using Ansible extensively, and in fact, I can run Ansible on my Raspberry Pi as well, and that's what I do here. So my Raspberry Pi sits there, this is my Ansible controller, and this is just more than enough processing power capacity that my Ansible node really needs. I don't have a very sophisticated like 1000 node setup, but for whatever I need for provisioning, for a bit of configuration management for my private cloud here, Ansible just gets the job done for me. And most of my configurations for my servers, for my applications, I have actually already migrated to Ansible. It's just been working so great. And that's the reason why I love Ansible. Thanks for watching this video, and if you like this content, do subscribe to this channel, and do give us a thumbs up or thumbs down based on you know, whether you liked it or not, and that will really help us to understand what kind of content you like, what kind of content we should generate. So I'll see you in another video.
If you like this content, do like, share, and subscribe. You may also find links to our free courses in the description below, along with some special offers for our premium courses. You could also visit us at schoolofdevops.com.